Welcome back to biology class. In a previous video, you studied about the different components of foods and also about the types and importance of carbohydrates. Now, in this video, you are going to study about the proteins and lipids. Now, proteins, these are the macromolecules having high molecular weight. These are the sources of proteins that you can see in the picture, which is the chicken, meat, fish, broccoli, nuts, legumes, then soya bean. These all provide good amount of proteins to the body. Now proteins, they are the compounds of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, and some proteins also contain sulfur and phosphorus. Now proteins, they are made up of amino acids, and there are about 20 types of amino acids which are categorized into two categories. These are essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. Essential amino acids are those amino acids which must be present in the diet, as they cannot be synthesized in the body. It means your diet must contain these amino acids to make the proteins inside the body, and these are 8 in number. Whereas non-essential amino acids can be synthesized in the body and you do not need to take it from the outside sources, and these are 12 in number. Now what is the importance of proteins? Proteins, these are the main body builders and are required for growth. They provide chemical materials for the growth, repair and replacement of worn out tissues. Enzymes that act as biocatalyst in the process of digestion are the functional proteins, and proteins are also used as fuel to release energy required for various metabolic activities when there is shortage of carbohydrates and fats. Means when the body is lacking in carbohydrates and fats, then these proteins are used as fuel to release energy. Some hormones which are required for the major functions of the body are also made up of proteins. Then antibodies which protect the body against diseases are also made up of proteins. And some proteins like hemoglobin also help in transportation. Like hemoglobin, it combines with oxygen and takes it from the lungs to the tissues. So in this way, you can see that these proteins are very important for our body. Now we will study about the lipids. Lipids means fats and oils. Now in this picture, you can see these various sources of fats such as fatty meats and fish, cheese, butter, avocado, nuts and seeds, chocolate, then there is ghee and oils, etc. And lipids, these are the compounds of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, like carbohydrates. But in lipids, the quantity of oxygen in proportion to hydrogen is very less. And these lipids are obtained from two sources, that is from the animal source and plant source. Animal fats, these are found in meat, milk, cheese, butter, ghee, egg yolk, etc. And plant fats, these are found in oils such as mustard oil, groundnut oil, sunflower oil, etc. And fats, these are made up of fatty acids and glycerols. Now, what is the importance of these lipids? Fats and oils, these are used as fuels to provide energy. 1 gram of fat on oxidation yields 9.4 kilocalories of energy, which is more than double the energy produced by equal amount of carbohydrates. It means lipids provide more energy than carbohydrates, and then they are the ideal material for the purpose of storage of food. It means food is stored in the body in the form of fats, and then fats, they form cushion like structures around brain, heart, kidneys to bear the shocks, as these are very important and delicate organs of the body. So a fatty layer forms a cushion like structure around them to bear the shocks. Then fatty layer, which is present below the skin, it acts as insulator to prevent the loss of heat from the body, and in this way it maintains the temperature of the body. and fats, they also act as solvent for fat soluble vitamins such as vitamin A, D, E and K. Then phospholipids, they help in the formation of cell membrane and other biomembrane systems, as the membrane of the cell is made up of these phospholipids. So in this way you can see that these proteins and lipids are very very important for our body. Now in this video you studied about proteins and lipids, and in the next video you are going to study about the vitamins and minerals, their principal sources and their deficiency effects on the body. Thank you. Have a nice day.